And good afternoon, everybody. This is Tony Fapiano coming to you from the Guilford Green on December 31st, actually New Year's Eve. And we're here for the 375th celebration. I'm going to bring my cameraman into the shot. This is Hayden Page. Hayden, thank you so much for doing this today. I appreciate it.
Of course.
The importance of you being here, you're much more important than me or anything else that's going on here because you're going to operate the camera all day. All right?
All right.
Tell me a little bit about yourself. You're, I understand, a high school student?
Yeah, I go to Fairfield Prep.
Oh, you do?
Yeah, I take the train every morning to school. I live in...
You take the train from Guilford?
Yep.
All the way to Fairfield?
Yep, and back.
You do? And what year?
I'm a sophomore.
Okay. Have you done anything with video before?
Not really.
All right, so this is going to be an adventure for both of us.
Yep.
All right, listen, what we're going to do today, you know this is going to be a long day. It starts at noon and it ends at 8 o'clock tonight. So we're going to try to get you as much of this as we can on tape so that people at home that could not be here today can actually witness some of the activities that took place and some of the stuff that the celebration committee has put together. Is your dad involved in this?
No, but my uncle is.
Your uncle, Stephen?
Page.
Yeah. Yeah, I know the pages, one page or another is always involved in something on the green. So you'll be next, by the way. So it's good that you're here getting your feet wet with this video.
Yeah.
All right, thanks very much, Hayden. Go back behind the camera. And what I'm going to do now is try to line up some of the committee people so that they can give you an overview of what actually is going to take place today. We're going to try to get as much as we can, but they have so many activities planned, I'm not certain that we'll be able to get everything. But bottom line, we'll get as much as we can. And right now, Hayden and I will take a break and we'll start working on some of the committee people. Okay, folks, I'm back on the green with the chairman. Actually, the entire year-long event.
That's
and
right.
Specifically, I guess we're going
to
talk.
This is our first signature event, Tony. So I'm very happy to wish everybody in Guilford and our community a happy new year. And please come out and support us.
So, oh, yeah, well.
Ring in 2014 and our 375th anniversary.
All right, well, so this one, obviously, this tape is probably not going to be seen by anybody until next week.
Right.
So what we're going to try to do is give people sort of a flavor of what went on here for those that attended some of it, part of it, none of it, whatever. If you're back at home watching, you'll be able to hopefully get an idea
of what happened here today. Right.
Yeah, you have so many things lined up. Let's start with the very, very beginning. You have the town photo.
Right.
What do you think is going to happen there?
Well, I'm hoping a lot of people show up. We're going to be over here in front of the town hall. We'll have a gathering of folks, and we'll have a fire truck, an aerial come up, a photographer that we've hired that is going to take an aerial photograph of everyone on the town green, and hopefully it'll be like a Where's Waldo, and people will come out and they'll try to find themselves. And
I'm excited about that.
Yeah,
I think that's going to be great.
I
hope
fun.
You get 10,000 people.
Yeah, it'd be fabulous if we got 10,000 people. Then immediately after that, we're going to have a noise parade. So pots, pans, spoons, whatever makes noise, we're going to travel around the green. And
I want to turn you into the sun so we get a good shot of your face. Go ahead.
Run around the green making noise and celebrating the new year. And hopefully,
and that's going to be an actual parade?
Yes, an actual parade. Well, we're not in the streets. We're on the green.
Okay.
The streets required us to have police and so forth and close off the road. So we're going to stay on the green. But it's a noise parade. And so anything that makes noise, gazoos, pots, pans, whatever, horns, it's led by Sam, I hope I say his name right, Aluri. He's the young gentleman from Baldwin Middle School that named us. It was a test that he won. He's going to be our grand marshal off, and everybody will follow him and make a lot of noise around the green.
And then you're going to disperse into different venues around the green and the community center.
That is correct.
So what happens after that?
Well, it's up to people and where they want to go, but we'll have events at the community center. We have the community center all day. There are things going on for young and old alike, starting with the senior lunch at noon, but then each of the rooms have activities for children. There's, make a snow globe. There's fish ponds. There's several groups that you can write on a mural, your New Year's resolutions, just anything that makes you feel good. There's something for everybody. The churches will all have concerts all afternoon. They're approximately 45 minutes to an hour long. They'll be...
Are they at the same time, or you have them staggered, or how do you do that?
They're at the same time, so, you know, and it's all in a book, so it depends on the type of music you're interested in. There's classical, there's jazz, there's folk music. 6, so it's all happening, you know, throughout the day till about 6 o'clock tonight. 6, I think, is the last one. And then at the end of the day, we'll have bonfire going on starting at about 4:30 this afternoon in the north section of the green.
Yeah, I wanted to ask you about that. You're going to put a bonfire right on the green?
Yes, right on the green.
Okay.
It will be probably barrels, and they're up by galvanized steel, so they're not going to actually do damage to our green, but we have permission to...
And what time is that?
We're going to start it probably around 4:30 when the sun starts to go down. It'll get cold and stuff, so it'll be a way for people to get warm and throw in their bad will and burn their anything they want to forget about.
And get warm.
And get warm. And then the fireworks will be a high shoot fireworks seen only from the green area starting at 8 o'clock.
Now, what do you mean on High Street? No,
I'm sorry. It'll be a high shoot.
Oh,
I'm sorry, I said High Street.
Yeah,
where are they doing
the firewood? Where are they going to originate from?
They will be originating from the fairgrounds, but the fairgrounds is closed off. People cannot go there because there are large mortars that are being used because it is a high shoot. So people will be able to see them from the green area. There's no foliage, so it's going to light up the Guilford skylight at 8 o'clock, and it'll all be seen from the downtown green area.
Now, this all sounds pretty expensive. I'm sure this isn't all free stuff. So you have sponsors and you also have cost of admission. So talk about cost of admission first.
Cost of admission.
And what's that for? What do you get into if you pay the admission cost?
Well, my committee started about a year and a half ago, and we've been fundraising to help defray some of the costs that are associated with the 5 signature events that we have planned, and this being our first event. Some of the concerts, the musical entertainment, is expensive. So we are selling bracelets. They're these green bracelets. I don't know if the camera can see it. There are keepsake too. As a keepsake.
It's got dates on it.
Right. It's 1639 to 2014, and it says Guilford 375.
Okay.
These bracelets are available at the community center, Pages, the town hall, and Bishops. What it's doing is adults are $12, seniors are $10, children are $8, and there's a family pack, a mother and a father, and if they have small children, doesn't matter how many, it's $24. And what that money does is help us pay for the police presence that we'll have here, the cost of the fireworks, and some of the musical entertainment that we have going on at the churches.
Yeah, that's an important note, too, when you come to the money part of this, because I think folks, we've said this before on one of the programs that you and I did, that the town is not paying for,
no.
The town budget is not paying for any of this.
Yeah,
this is all
right.
Being funded by your committee.
Right. And
so it's important.
So that's why we started like a year and a half ago raising money to help defray the costs, and because there are unseen costs that people aren't aware of, like I said, the police and fire presence, and we have to pay some of the entertainment folks and vendors and supplies and things like that. So
that's what
the money is going to help us defray those costs.
Now, that was a conscious decision by either you or the Board of Selectmen to not have the budget pay for this and have it be funded by the attendees, I guess.
That is correct.
So that discussion, I'm sure, took place at the very, very beginning.
Right, that is correct.
Okay.
Yeah, no taxpayer money is being used to fund any activities of the 375th anniversary.
I just paid my taxes. I'm happy to hear that.
Yeah.
Anyway,
me too.
Yeah, right.
Me too.
So the bottom line is that the money that you generate here is going to hopefully take care of everything.
Yeah, we hope it's going to be a break-even event.
What if it doesn't?
Yeah. Well, like I said, we've been doing fundraising, so you know, we hope that this event will be a break-even event and that we'll have enough money to cover it. But we'll do more fundraising if we have to. Yeah.
All right. You also have sponsors.
Fireworks are costly. The shoot tonight is going to run between $8,000 and $10,000.
Really?
So, yeah. Okay. So fireworks are expensive, and you know, you can't have that in the town budget. So we had to raise a substantial amount of money.
No, I fully agree with that decision, but I think it's important for folks at home to know what you did.
Yeah, me too.
So again, you also have some sponsors that are helping out.
I do, and I guess that's the most important thing that I want to say is shop local and support our businesses here in Guilford. They have been absolutely, unequivocally so supportive of all the events that we've been doing. Our partners are Guilford Savings Bank, Bishop's Orchards, Page Hardware, East River Energy, and Yale New Haven Hospital.
They ponied up the big bucks.
Yeah, they ponied up the big bucks. So, you know, shop local, shop often, and like I said, the Guilford businesses are outstanding, absolutely outstanding. They've they've done a lot for us.
All right, now it's now 10 after 11.
That's right.
And your photo is going to take place at noon.
Noon, right over here in front of Town Hall, you know, and hopefully we have a lot of people that will gather and we'll have a good time.
And you're going to bring the fire truck right onto the green here?
The fire truck will be on Park Street, and it'll be up, and people will be on the green. So the photographer will be up in the aerial bucket, and we'll take it downward.
Okay. Actually, I saw them practicing in front of Pages one morning.
Yeah.
They must have changed the location.
We had to change it because today is a very busy day for some of our vendors, our local businesses. So we changed it to come over here on Park Street. So
what are you going to do with the photograph?
The photograph is going to be available for sale, and again, it helps defray the cost of what we're doing. And so we're also going to take it and insert it into our commemorative book, which will be published the end of January 2014. And that will also be, for a donation, a minor donation, all sorts of historical stories and things about Guilford, and some advertisements and photographs and things that people would be interested in knowing. So the photograph will be in that book, and it'll also be available for sale separately.
Okay. Now, I know you already ran a couple of events that were fundraisers for you,
yeah.
The auction being one at
the Yacht Club,
mm-hmm. And then you also had some dances, I think, too. So hopefully that generated some bucks for
yes.
you.
Yes. Yep.
Okay.
Yeah.
The important thing for people to know is that they have to know about this.
Yep.
Because this is going to be successful when you get people here. And if they miss out, they're really missing something important.
Well, that's true. And we hope that since this is our first signature event, that we hope it's successful. I'm pretty sure that it's going to be. Then the other thing, if for more information, because I guess this is going to air after...
Yeah,
today's
yeah
events.
After today, yeah.
Yeah, is we have a website. It's GuilfordCT375.org. GuilfordCT375.org. And there's, I'm making a plea, too, for people. If you have a story, we'd love to hear your story. What brought you to Guilford? What do you love about Guilford? Anything you want to say. We're putting up people's stories, and I'm telling you, we got some really...
Is that right?
Yeah, really interesting... wonderful stories about what brought people to Guilford, and how welcoming the town is, and just really interesting stuff. So if we're looking for submissions.
Okay, let's do a quick commercial. What's your next event?
My next event is at the Yacht Club.
You probably, by the end of the day, you won't even think about the next one yet, but there is a next one, so
yes.
What is it?
March 29th, 2014, we're having what we're calling the Crystal Ball. It's at the Yacht Club. It's a Saturday evening, and it's a black tie affair. Ticket prices haven't been settled on yet, but it's going to be a wonderful evening at the Yacht Club. We have eight to the bar. They're donating...
Oh, great. Yep.
One of our sponsors, Ocean Marketing, is sponsoring 8 to the Bar for us. So that's going to be a great, fun night. Fun
Black Tie Affair,
Black Tie Affair, and just a big birthday party, really, is what it's going
to
be.
All right, and you made reference to your website, GuilfordCT375.org.
That's correct.
I guess all of the events that you have scheduled, you said it's going to be five altogether.
Yes.
This is the first of five.
Right.
All of those are available on the website?
Yes, they are. Yeah.
All right, what else you want to add?
Just stay tuned, and we're going to have a lot of fun this year, 2014, and I thank everybody, including our sponsors, for helping us carry this off, and thank you for donating all your services and helping us get the word out. That's been a real problem for us, is advertising, getting coverage and things like that. Guilford Courier is also one of our partnerships. They've been doing a good job at getting our message out, but it seems, you talk about something like this, or you come into New Year's, it's like, oh, there's going to be something going on. It's like people, it's really funny. Really funny.
Well, you've had a lot of publicity, but not everybody reads everything.
Right.
So,
spread
the
word.
You can bring the horse to you can't make them drink.
Yeah.
You know.
So spread the word and talk it up, because that's what the community is all about. And I'm very happy to be chairman. And I thank you again for your services. And I thank the residents of the town and most of the town departments for helping us. Public Works, Fire, Police, they've all been fabulous.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So. All right, Veronica, I'm looking forward to the photograph.
Me
now, listen,
too.
Who's going to be up in the bucket up there?
Karen, I think her name is. Wait a minute, I'll tell you who the photographer is.
Is there room for a videographer up there?
You have to take that up with Steve Page.
I don't know if he wants his nephew to go up there.
You know,
he might fall off.
I don't know if
it's in here. I forget her name. Always.
Well, we'll
catch
it when you set up. How's that? Yeah, what we're going to do is wherever you set up, we'll get the camera set up, we'll get everybody assembling, and then we're going to run into the photograph because we want to be in the picture.
Yeah, and she's a professional photographer, so it's going to be a really very nice photo. I'm sorry I can't find the name, and I'm sorry it's escaping.
We'll catch up to
it. Right there. Catherine Kiernan Photography will be taking the photograph.
Yeah, I know Catherine. Yeah. She does an excellent job. Yeah. And again, I saw her practicing in different locations on the green, so I'm sure she's picking the right angle with the sun and everything else.
Yeah.
The sun's always an issue with these. All right.
All right.
Veronica,
thanks,
thanks so much. I'll see you later. Thank you.
Thanks to our cameraman.
Okay.
All right.
Woohoo! It's always a good time now.
Do they want us to move back or are they still trying to figure it out?
The ocean.
Okay, folks, you probably noticed I'm up here with Adam, who's a volunteer fireman or a paid fireman. Are you on the fire department?
I am, volunteer.
Volunteer. And you're controlling this bucket. How many feet up in the air?
Right now, probably 40 or 50.
Where are we going from here?
Going out and up.
You've done this before, Adam?
A couple times.
All right. Catherine, you're going to do the photograph?
Yes, I am.
So how many shots?
Couple thousand.
Yeah, I'll bet you'd be clicking them off. I see you got a couple of cameras with you.
Yes, I do.
All right, it's going to be fun.
Only the best.
All right.
Thank you.
Catherine, do you know where the photos are going to be available?
They'll be available on the website for the 375th celebration, Jubilee celebration.
Okay.
And on my Facebook page, Kiernan Photography.
These are going to be for sale, aren't they? As a fundraiser for the group?
Sure, yes they are.
Yeah. All right.
Thank you. find the early years of American rock and roll.
Now here for all of the youngsters of the country and Canada are amazing, thrilling, really spectacular, incredible, exciting, wonderful, world fame, most unusual.
All right, here we go.
Take you all in the history of early rock and roll from the year 1950 up to the year 1965. It's kind of an interesting program because not only is it a history of early rock and roll in America, it's also a history of America too. So sit back and relax as we recall some good old tunes that went like this. In the 30s and 40s, the newest style of jazz called swing. But swing music was being played by mostly white musicians with little of the passion, emotion, and improvisation of the original African-American jazz style. Consequently, some black musicians did not like it when the traditional hot jazz became sweeter. Swing music. So they revived another of their African-American music inventions, the blues, the sorrow and hardship song sung by African-Americans during and after their many years of slavery here in the United States, an outgrowth of their religious spirituals and work songs. In the 1940s, they added a new and powerful rhythm to blues, called it rhythm blues, eventually would lead to rock and roll. There were several features of the 1830s blues which carried down through the decades and became part of the 1940s rhythm and blues. The first feature is what we call falsetto, where the lead singer or head worker would sing really high so everybody could hear him clearly. 1830 spiritual falsetto like, "Nobody knows the trouble I've seen except Jesus," transformed the 1940s rhythm and blues falsetto to sound a little something like this. La 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 la. Originally field hollers, they were shouts of pain and frustration, pleas to the gods for help. 1840s work yells like, "Lord, my hands are so tired," transformed the 1940s rhythm and blues yells to sound a little something like this.
Yeah! You know you made me.
The third feature of the blues is what we call and response. Originally, this meant the leader of the work crew would sing out a phrase. All the workers would repeat the phrase, and everybody would use the rhythm of the song to help them perform a single task together. For example, here's an 1840s work call and response song, get ready to repeat after me.
I work my fingers to the bone.
Work my fingers to the bone.
And I'm so far away from home.
And I'm so far away from home.
Transformed the 1940s rhythm and blues call and response to sound like this.
Heidi, 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 heidi.
Hi, 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 hi.
Hey, 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 come on.
Hey, 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 hey.
I'm better looking every day.
Better looking every day.
I just made that up. See if any of you recognize either of these call and response songs from the early days of rock and roll. Check it out. Well, you know you make me want to shout. It was Chicago blues with guys like Bo Diddley.
Bo Diddley, call us Danny Go.
Kansas City blues with guys like Big Joe Turner.
Shake, ride and roll. Shake, ride and roll.
New Orleans blues with guys like Fats Domino.
I'm walking through, hear the need, I'm talking, but hearing me, I'm walking.
Also from New Orleans, the one and only Little Richard.
Yes, I'm Uncle John with four and Sally. Somebody come join us, I can get to have you, baby. Oh, baby. Oh, baby. I have to be some fun tonight. Everybody clap your hands.
Western singers adding rhythm to their old hillbilly tunes. They called it rockabilly music. There was a revival of an old African American piano style.
Hold on, wait till she's done.
Oh, wow. Thank you.
Go ahead. Oh, try again. Try
again. No. No.
This is Emir. Emir. I say it wrong. I'm so sorry.
That's okay.
She is the oil painting teacher here for the seniors. And so this room actually is a display of the oil paintings of some of the students and the teacher. And we also have the senior crafts.
I'm going to get a view of this.
Sure. Should we still talk?
Okay, what else do you have?
We have knitting on this table. This is all handmade by senior citizens. We have sewing on this table, likewise handmade by senior citizens. These are crafts. made by the senior citizens.
And everything else are my students.
Yeah. So now, the crafts and the sewing and the knitting, actually, you can find things like these and more at the annual bazaar at the end of October. So look for that. But this is just a sampling of some of the stuff.
Is for sale today also?
If they're interested, they can leave their name, but we're not selling it as such today.
Okay.
So please come up and see our exhibit.
All right, thank you. Here. Somebody must know what this is.
You got to edit that out. Barb can talk. Billy can talk. So there's lots of art supplies you can bring home.
You'll have to be grateful for you. Make a card.
Two.
Sure, Grandma, that's what I'd be grateful for. Do you want to make a favor?
And it doesn't have to be for Pam. It could be like,
number, do you want it?
Yes, FG830.
Oh, those are important.
Those are important.
Okay.
Okay.
Well,
like mother.
Okay. Anything about it.
Coordinating the volunteers. Oh my goodness. What's we have? I'm on camera right now. What am I supposed to say?
What are the tickets for?
Were the tickets? These aren't tickets, actually. The tickets are for meals for the volunteers. People that have donated their time, including Pilgrim Fellowship and a couple of Scout troops in the area, Troop 472. Was one of them, and some various volunteers in the community volunteered to help out. So,
sounds good.
And they get free food.
As well, all right. But you don't have to worry, though. We don't feed her poison berries. That would be unethical, not to mention an insurance liability. Like I said, we're just going to look at her because we don't want her to poke us by accident. But she's very, very cute when she walks. Go on, show us how you walk. Come on. She walks kind of like she got a carpet on her back.
Tickle, tickle, tickle. What you doing, silly girl?
Hi.
He's sitting up in
the back. What are you doing? Go in here.
Here, let's bring her and take a look at you. She looks really cute from below.
Extreme close-up.
She's a cutie because he's so cute and he's so furry. And this is my friend, Mr. Klinger, and he's a Chilean rose-haired tarantula. And he's a cool little guy, too.
Does he bite?
No, he does not. No, he does not. Now, don't worry. This is another animal. We're just going to be looking at Mr. Klinger. We're not touching Mr. Klinger, just like with Miss Stevie. But the reason being, though, it's not that he's not friendly, because he is. He's just very fragile. He's very delicate. He breaks very easily. That's all. See, Mr. Klinger here, guys, he is an arachnid, so he has an exoskeleton. He's got a hard outer shell. In a way, he's kind of like a giant walking egg. If you crack an eggshell, leaks out, it's no good anymore. Well, if we cracked his shell, he'd probably leak out just like an egg. He'd probably end up dying, which is what we don't want. Well, most of us don't want that to happen, guys, okay? So we just look at Mr. Klinger today, but we're not touching him, okay? But I assure you, though, it's not that he's not friendly. If he wasn't friendly, I wouldn't be holding on to him.
How do you know he's a he?
How do I know he's a he? Because that's what they told me.
No, not me.
Hey, now you're on camera. Go ahead.
Go. Wait, I need this space right here. I gotta. Oh, you just.
Oh,
sorry.
Just
okay, guys.
Just
guys,
go.
That was not on purpose. Okay. So you know you're really cool. Woo!
Are there any more pool sticks?
I can't. I literally cannot play pool.
They said
for
everything's
in place. Like, I don't know why I'm being filmed.
Are you having fun?
All right, Veronica, how are we doing so far?
We're doing fabulous, Tony. Thanks for asking.
What's going on? Have you been around all the different venues?
The community center is packed. The churches are grooving and rocking, and everybody seems to be having a good time, and things are going very well.
We have enough kids here at the community center.
Yep, we do. We've got a lot of a lot of volunteers are helping out, so that makes our job a lot easier. And I understand you took a ride up in the ladder truck. Did you have fun yourself up there?
All right. We went to one concert, the rock and roll.
Yeah.
That was great.
Yeah.
The guy went through the history of rock and roll.
Oh, that's great.
Gave you a whole background. Very good. Ryan Gilley, I think?
Yeah. Yes. Yeah.
Good job. Yeah. Anita, what do you got there?
I have a little tuna sandwich.
This is what, a volunteer meal?
This is a volunteer meal.
All right.
We got to feed our volunteers, you know.
Well, I got a volunteer cameraman behind me here.
He's welcome to have something.
All right. Hayden, you hungry? Not yet.
So,
Larry, what are you guys doing in here?
We're doing some soups and we're doing some sandwiches.
This is for who? This is for the volunteers?
Yeah, well, for the volunteers or anybody else that's visiting the center today that wants
to. So what's on the menu? But
there's tuna fish sandwiches, there's hot dogs, cheese sandwiches, we got tomato soup, we got chicken soup.
All right, looks
pretty
good.
Much it. We kept it simple.
You got a lot of people out there, so you might be busy.
Uh-oh.
Janet, what are you doing here?
I'm selling food.
You're selling food?
Hey, yeah.
This is for the public.
This is for the public. Anybody
right,
can come in. We've got soup, because it's kind of chilly out there today. We've got tuna fish sandwiches. We've got grilled cheese. We've got hot dogs. Coffee, again, because it's kind of chilly. Water, Diet Coke, and Coke.
Now how's business so far?
We're just starting up, so it's
okay,
almost hungry time.
A
lot of people out there.
Have you been around to all the different venues?
Not to all of them, but a couple. And we've been to a couple of the merchants that are staying open late today, so.
Oh, good deal.
Yeah, good deal.
Janet is the executive director of the Guilford Chamber of Commerce, which is about to merge with Brantford and become what?
We are now the Shoreline Chamber of Commerce, the Guilford-Brantford Alliance.
All right, sounds good. That's a long name.
That is a long name.
Are my dues going up?
Of course.
He takes care of me. Tony takes care of me. Every Tony.
All right, Ralph Chapin. Oh, who else?
Tony Anicelli.
You got a madhouse here, Ralph. What's going on?
Absolutely. Oh, 375th and using our facilities, so Park and Rec facilities. For a good portion of the day, till like 6, 7 o'clock tonight.
And a ton of volunteers.
Yes, loads of volunteers. That's because Sue Jacobson, who is our Park and Rec Commissioner, representative on the 375th Committee, along with Rose Dastard, did a great job of soliciting help to man the various...
Yeah, what was the relationship between the Park and Rec Commission and the 375th Committee?
Basically, supporter. Yes, there was. And we had two active members of our commission.
Strictly platonic relationship.
Always platonic, Tony. You know how it is at our age.
Trying to spice up the program. You know what I mean, Ralph?
You want to spice up the program? We can get some young women to interview.
You got Nancy over here.
Oh, Nancy's
hey,
always
Howard.
Here.
Nancy's answering the phone.
She's on the phone. You want to hold?
It's very, very interesting, and so far everything's been positively received, so they did a great job.
It's working well.
Yep.
Thanks, Ralph.
No problem.
Do you take it for your meal?
So this is a our first Happy New Year face.
Is it?
Right? Who are you?
Pam Stannard.
Nice to see you.
Nice.
Where'd you get that hat?
I got it in the dollar store.
Oh, it looks great.
Thank you.
Are you having fun?
Yes.
Great time here, isn't it?
Oh, I'm having a blast. Yeah.
Good to see you.
Good to see you.
I am Peggy Russell, and I own Shoreline Creative Arts Boutique, which is on the west side of Route 1 in Guilford. We have 38 Connecticut artists. We are a Connecticut artist-only boutique. We have everything from textiles and wood to stained glass.
See what you got here.
Okay.
All right.
We have textiles, we have stained glass, we have soaps and candles and jewelry, photography. We have asked some of our artists to come up with Guilford specific art. So we have lobster buoys, we have photographs, we have a turkey table runner to go with Gazi's Turkey Farm here. We have Guilford t-shirts, zip code magnets, you name it, we have it. We have incredible artists that are very talented and creative and have a lot of inspiration. So come on down. All and right. 10% of all the proceeds of our Guilford specific art is going to the committees for the trail completion and for the 375 celebration.
Thank you.
What do you serve? Anyway.
Here we go, more chickens now. Dance as high as you can. Not yet. Get down.
Oh, oh, like an angel.
So that you're not tilting.
actually think it's much harder to keep your balance and keep your knees bent a little bit.
So right now you're stomping on the ground. Good music. And you're jumping right over. All right, every time you say cha-cha, you cha-cha and you turn to your left. So face the windows.
One hop this time. One hop this time. Right foot, two stops. Crisscross. Cha-cha, real smooth.
We're gonna cha-cha and turn and face the painting on the wall there.
Let's go to work. To the left. How low can you go? Can you bring it to the top? Like it never, never stop. Cha-cha, real smooth.
All right, cha-cha, turn to face the door.
To the left. Slide to the right. Reverse, reverse. Reverse, reverse. Cha-cha now, y'all. Cha-cha again.
Cha-cha, turn
up.
You can make your feet for the count is out loud.
Featuring the band, and this time we're gonna get.
All right, clap your hands. Everybody should be off the baller app.
Everybody clap your hands. Clap, 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 clap your hands. Clap, 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 clap your hands. All right now.
All right, here we go.
Basic step to the left.
Jump on it.
Take it back now, y'all. One out this time.
Let's go, let's go. Let's go, let's go. All right, we gotta
go to the music, bro. Turn it up. To the left. Take it back now, y'all. One hop this time. Right foot, let's go. Left foot, let's go. Cha-cha now, y'all. Last time. One hop this time. Right foot, two steps. Left foot, two steps. Slide to the left. Slide to the right. Crisscross. Crisscross. Cha-cha, real smooth. Let's go to work. To the left. Take it back now, y'all. Two hops this time. Two hops this time. Right foot, two stops. Left foot, two stops. Hands on your knees. Hands on your left foot now, y'all. Cha-cha, real smooth.
Turn and face the door. Face the door.
To the left. Turn it out. To the left. Take it back now, y'all. Four hops this time. Right foot now.
got 20 seconds on the blue to draw.
What have you thought about color?
Right here.
Right there.
I want it.
Okay. What do you want to do with that?
I want it.
Are those real?
Real.
Did it come off?
Oh, yeah, in about a week.
They do?
Yes. Charlotte, look into it.
Oh.
Do you see that? See that?
That one.
See that? Okay.
The director of music at St. George Church across the way. And so delighted to have so many of you in attendance for this very special performance. As you know, this is our Generations Jubilee, and this inaugurates our 375th celebration, anniversary celebration of the town of Guilford. So thank you to all of you for being here today and helping us to celebrate this joyous, glorious occasion. You are in for a very, very special treat, so I'm thrilled that so many people are here. I've been very fortunate to know Charlie here of Dupont Artists for a few years now, having taught one of his sons when I started at Guilford High School, and heard of the many, many wonderful, wonderful things that Dupont Artists brings to the table, musically speaking and as performers in general. This group has been in existence for about 20 years, or a full 20 years, if I'm correct. We're trying to get a name nailed down, but we couldn't quite decide on that. But nonetheless, they are truly a remarkable group of gentlemen with a superb program to present to you this afternoon. I'm not going to do any more extension on my introduction, because I think they have a more formal one to share for you. But I hope you will join me in welcoming to the stage here at Christ Episcopal Church, the Dupont Artists. Thank you.
Okay, as part of the celebration today, all of the firehouses in town are open to the public for the kids to come and look and see what's here and climb on the trucks and so forth. We are at the firehouse on Graves Avenue, which
Washington
is what?
Washington Engine Company 1.
Washington Engine.
Yes, we okay. were organized in 1852.
Yeah, how do you know that?
Well, it's up on the side of the firehouse.
Somebody told you that.
Yeah, it's on the side of our fire truck and on the side of the firehouse.
Right.
And,
what's your name?
Doug McGee. I'm a lieutenant here at the firehouse.
Okay. Now, your fire department, you have some volunteers, but more paid than you used to have in the old days.
Yeah.
What do you have now? What's the breakdown?
Percentage of volunteers? I think there's 8 folks on shift now each day, and there's about 40 active volunteer firefighters that we have. So it's starting to equalize. It's a hard commitment for volunteers.
And you're always looking for volunteers.
And we are. We're always looking for volunteers to do the Firefighter 1 training and commit to all the hours above work is hard for people, but we're always looking for volunteers. We'd love to have people come join us, and that's one of the reasons why we opened the firehouses up, to see if we can have the kids bring their dads in, and maybe we can entice them or their moms to be a part of this with us.
Is there an age limit? I mean, are you too old?
No, you're never too old. As long as you can...
What a nice guy, huh?
As long as you can pass...
You could have said you old son.
As long as you... There's a physical and an entry process, and as long as you get through that, there's lots of things to do. There's fire police, there's firefighting. There's always need outside of the fire, go for stuff off the fire truck and changing air packs, so you don't always have to be in interior. You could join in. There's always, you know, something someone can do within their comfort level.
All right. Now, if there was a fire right now, let's say 2 blocks away, and it was in your district, how long would it take for the volunteers to get here and get your team together to get out there and do what you had to do?
A lot of us live close by. It takes us typically about 5 minutes or less to get down here. If there's no traffic and it's nighttime, we get down here a little bit quicker. But we get out fairly quick. We have members that work for the town and are near town hall, so they come over. Okay. Sometimes if they're in the office and available, they get here quicker. Yeah. So we get on the air pretty much right behind the apparatus that come out of headquarters fairly quickly.
But you're right, the commitment is huge. It's so different now than it was. The economy is more different now than it was in 1852, obviously. You had so many people that lived in town, worked in town, did everything here.
Right.
Now you have so many people that work elsewhere. So.
It's hard for the businesses to let people out as they did in the past. Page's used to be a huge supporter, and a lot of folks would leave Page's Hardware and other downtown stores to come and volunteer and go to calls, and now it's, you know, it's harder for a volunteer to get out of work.
Right. Now, you were open to the public today. What did you, if a kid walked in right now, what would you have him do? What would you like him to do?
If a kid came in now, they could come in, sit.
Don't pull the fire alarm for one, right?
Yeah, don't pull the fire alarm, but they can come in and sit in the driver's seat. They could ride, you know, pretend they're riding in the back of the fire truck, and we would give them a tour of the fire truck and in the firehouse as well, some of the amenities we have here. So.
Now, you do that for one of the fairs on the green. You have your truck set up. I think, I'm trying to think which one of the activities in the summer activities.
We do Little Folks Fair. We're part of the Harvest Festival. Sometimes we'll have the trucks down at the Guilford Fairgrounds and let kids go through it and see the fire trucks.
I know my grandchildren love it, so it's a good thing. So keep doing that.
Yeah, we enjoy it. We love having the public in. And we're also open on Halloween. We give out candy and we're here.
Oh, I might Halloween come by night, for that.
So, yeah.
I could do the candy.
Yeah. So we try to have it open for families to come down as many times a year as we can. And some Sundays we're here and people can stop in and visit too if they want.
All right, Lieutenant, thank you so much. I appreciate your time and the information.
Thank you. You're welcome.
Okay, folks, yet another activity going on today. It's a phenomenal number of events and activities that the 375th Committee has put together. But one that's starting to fill up right now is in the new hall at St. George Church. And it's the men's club is sponsoring the bingo?
No, it's not. It's not. Actually, no, it's the Knights of Columbus.
Oh, the Knights of Columbus.
Knights
okay.
Of Columbus, okay.
So the Knights are doing this.
The Knights
and,
of Columbus, yep.
How'd you get involved with the committee, the 375th committee?
I was asked to be in the committee by virtue of the parish, people knowing people in Guilford, and asked me if that would host a bingo here for the celebration of the 375th anniversary. So we got together with a couple of guys, and here we are. So yeah. We're getting ready to get started. So.
And the Knights are good at this. They do this every week.
We do this every week. Absolutely, yes, we do.
Okay.
It's a free bingo. There's no money to be won. It's fun. We'll explain some of the bingo games, and you win candy. Is what we're going to give away. Is candy.
Yeah, I was going to.
We're actually having a good fun time, and we're providing all the setup for a normal bingo. We normally have a Monday night bingo at our hall every Monday night. So yeah,
what's the time of that? What time is that?
It goes from 5 to 10 o'clock every Monday night.
And that's for big bucks. People can win money there.
That's for money winning. Yeah, you actually pay to get in, and you're going to win some money. So this is just for fun, and I think it's a really good time. People are starting to show up here, so we're going to get ready to get started pretty soon. So.
All right, and what's your name?
My name is Vinny Ruiz.
Okay,
Vinny. I am one of the team captains of the bingo.
At the KSC
Hall, yeah. So very involved in the community and the church, and I'm here.
And here you are.
Here we are. So.
Be careful what you wish for. This is
absolutely
what happens. It's just like the Army, you know. Don't when you volunteer, that's the end of it. Keep volunteering.
Yeah, keep volunteering.
It never goes away.
It goes. That's it. So right, thank you. Very
thanks
much.
Thanks a lot. Thanks for the information. Okay, folks, another activity. I'm with Adam, who actually I started the day with.
Yes.
Adam was running the hook and ladder and brought us up to the top so the photographer could get a shot and graciously allowed me to go along with you. So I appreciate that, Adam, first
of all. No problem.
But secondly, you have a bonfire going here. When the committee contacted you guys and said we want to do a bonfire on the green, what was the reaction?
We're ready to help. So it's good for the community. It's going to bring everyone together to the green and keep people warm, too, hopefully. It's a cold night.
Yeah, especially now the wind is whipping up a little bit.
Yes.
Now, what are the safety precautions you have to take?
We've got extra fire extinguishers around. We've got cones set up to keep people away from the fire, obviously. Bunch of firemen on staff here, and we've got people manning the firehouses as well. So
yeah, and you're just starting this now. What time will it go till?
I believe it goes till about 8 o'clock, and then once the fireworks go off, then we're gonna clean it up.
Okay, and you're burning a whole bunch of skids here, and you got some hay as well. So
absolutely, yep, just pallets and hay.
Yeah,
right.
Well, where'd you get the donated from somebody?
The pallets were donated by Page Hardware.
Oh, they were?
Yes.
Okay, that's
yes.
Good. Yeah, the cameraman was donated by Page Hardware, too.
Oh, good, good.
But bottom line, this is another fantastic thing about today. I thought today was just great. Were you able to see any of the stuff that went on here?
We were walking around, and we were hanging out for a little bit after we did the ladder truck and saw the kids running around with the pots and pans, and lots of people walking around in green and all the community efforts. Yeah. It's been great, yeah.
And the community center was jammed today.
Absolutely.
There had to be 1,000 little kids over there.
Very good.
It was great.
Good.
So.
That's what it's about, right?
Yeah. Adam, thanks so much.
Thank you.
All right. Good
all
to
right.
see you. go over there, then we'll come back here.
Okay.
All right.
Okay, folks, another fantastic activity that the 375th Committee has put together is this photo booth. And this is kind of a unique photo booth, but I have actually seen this before because I've seen you before at some of the parties I attend. Your name is?
I'm Ron Glick.
Okay, and you, this belongs to you, correct?
Yeah, this is a new photo booth we have here. It's color changing. It's all automated. You can just go up, type in the background that you want from over 100 different backgrounds, and you'll see yourself on the screen live.
Yeah, I just saw some. Let me see that shark photo if you still have it.
Oh, yeah.
That's kind of an interesting.
Isn't that amazing?
You set the background.
Yeah, so they pick the shark out of the book, and then they position themselves. You can see what it looks like on the screen. Then you just press start, and it counts down and takes your picture.
Yeah, last time I saw you, you were doing Christmas photos at Iannuzzi's party in East Haven, correct?
Yeah, that's right. Breakfast with Santa, yeah.
And you were the DJ that day as well, and you were DJ here today. That was a lot of fun. You had, I don't know how many kids you had going, but the place was mobbed.
Yeah. Yep, they have a good time.
Was the bubble wrap thing your idea?
Actually, David Ott's been doing that with me for the past few years. We do that at the 8th grade dance at Adams School, and also we chose to do it for this too.
Yeah. Now, are you a teacher?
I used to teach in Guilford, but now I stay at home with my two girls.
Oh, okay. And when you taught in Guilford, where were you?
I was at Guilford Lakes.
Okay. Yeah, it's a great school.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's a great school system, actually.
Yep.
Well, we really enjoy everything that you do. Not only here, but the times I've seen you at some of the parties I've attended. You do a great job. You're a you're terrific DJ.
Thank you.
You really get everybody going. And the kids just had a ball today.
Great, great. Glad everybody's having a good time.
Okay, I want to see somebody take a picture here.
We got to get the line over there.
Can we do that?
Sure, you can take a picture.
Good one.
At the